Hello everyone, in this week's After Effects scripting tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to better learn After Effects scripting by yourself and some steps that I would take and recommend to do so. So as most of you know, After Effects scripting can be very complicated at times, so sometimes it can seem really hard to get through learning it. So I just wanted to go over a few tips and give you guys some tips and tricks of how I learned. So the first thing is to always reference the scripting guide and the UI guide. I'll have all the resources in the description, including these links, but you basically want to make sure that you're always learning about what's inside of the scripting guide. Make sure you check old and new versions to see what features have been implemented recently or what features are now obsolete. The scripting guide is very useful because everything is organized in an object mode so that we can actually see the hierarchy of how everything works inside of After Effects from the application level all the way down to the property or parameter level. And there's also the script UI, which is designed for InDesign actually, but it does apply for any other types of scripts that you could be making. And this script is basically just going to allow us to learn everything we need to know about making UIs. And it even has included example code as well as images for what all the code does. So again, this one will also be in the description. The next thing I would recommend is constant code review. If you're not reading a language when you're learning it, you're not going to be able to speak it or write it. So it's important to always be taking a look at least some code, whether it be syntactical and not even JavaScript, or just straight JavaScript extended for After Effects. Inside of every version of After Effects, inside of your support files, After Effects includes plenty of unencoded scripts that you can load up, check out the code inside, and learn all about scripting. Another important thing is to debug. And debugging is sort of like teaching yourself again or removing bad coding habits. And the main things you want to do when debugging is just finding general errors in your code. We can do this by doing things like alerts, or we can even use the built-in write line function, and we can tell the user things while they're going through the script. And to see an alert, it'll automatically pop up on the screen, but to see a system write line, we need to go to Window and JavaScript console, and any system level messages will be displayed inside of this console. And along with debugging, you'll also want to debug different versions of what you're coding for. So if you have a script that you've only been using Adobe After Effects 2018 for, well, it might not work in, say, CS6 or CC2014. There are some features that aren't implemented in the older versions of After Effects that have been put in recently. So always be sure to be testing not just in extend script, but also in the versions of After Effects you're expecting to work in. And also along those lines, not just on Windows, but you also want to test things on Mac. Because often some code won't work on Mac, especially if you're using folder structures. The next piece of advice I could give you is to make sure you visit any forums for After Effects scripting. These are the most helpful places to go to if your answers cannot be found in your head, in the UI guide, in the scripting guide, or just talking to close friends who know about scripting. I find that even when I can't come up with something after days of practice and trial and error or talking to my friends, the last place and where most of the answers will be found is here. And of course, before you post something, be sure to search through on the forums first. If you just post something and that thread already exists somewhere, you're not going to get the best welcome to the community. Another hyper important thing is to use object level thinking. Inside of extend script, we can load up the object model viewer, which for us will describe all of the JavaScript core classes built into JavaScript extended, as well as we can have access to script UI classes and program-specific classes. This is very important because we can go in here and say, look at, if I want to access a file, I can see all of the constructors, instances, and classes involved with it, all the attributes and properties that I can call, read, and write from it, as well as you can see the actions we can apply to it. Knowing how different object levels work in After Effects is incredibly important, because I often find myself messing up lines of code because I accidentally misunderstood part of the scripting guide or how the object model works. For example, if I had a composition and I wanted to add a layer to it, like a solid, I would typically just say comp.addSolid. But anyone who's used After Effects scripting knows that that would not work because we need to have comp.layers.solid. And the same thing goes for any app.project level things. If we wanted to say add an AV item or something, that would not work because we need to also reference the project items. So it's important to know the object level and how everything is organized, which you can also again see inside of the scripting guide. It has a nice object model view here, and also inside of the object model viewer inside of ExtendScript, we can also view this for UI classes and others. Another way to learn, although a lot harder, is to watch tutorials. The only ones I can recommend are my own and David Torno's, where there's about 19 or so tutorials, I believe, on his website, videoprocoalition.com. But you want to watch lots of tutorials, not just to learn, but also to get ideas, which you can also get from websites like VideoHive in the After Effects script category. But of course, don't steal from these artists, just get ideas and see if you can come up with anything more unique than them. And the final piece of advice I can give to you guys. The best way to learn anything is to do it by yourself and force yourself to do it. The way I initially learned how to use After Effects scripts was just to set a goal and slowly work towards it. I first told myself, okay, I want to have a script that can turn on and off all my layers. So what do I first need to do? Well, the first thing I should probably do is learn how to turn off a layer and turn on a layer with the script. Then I need to figure out how I can do it to multiple layers, and in this case, all of them. And the biggest thing is just to push through any struggles that you have. That's the fun part and the hard part about coding, is problem solving. Although we're not doing high-level math or computer science inside of JavaScript right now, there's still going to be a lot of problems and some code bugs that are going to take forever to fix. And once you realize that there's just an extra comma or a period, you're going to feel so stupid afterwards. But you'll know for next time to look out for that. And it's those little things that you learn along the way that will just help you become a lot better of a programmer. So that's going to be it for this tutorial, guys. I hope you enjoyed. That's how you can teach yourself or start learning After Effects scripting by yourself. If you guys enjoyed these tips, make sure to hit the like button and also hit the subscribe button with the bell button next to it to be notified of new uploads coming out every Monday. If you have any questions or comments, of course, leave them down below in the comments section. And be sure to check out all of the other videos that I've talked about today down in the description below. Alright guys, that's going to do it for this video. Next week we're going to be back to tutorials. So thanks again for watching, and we'll see you then.